The Jogelli Show.
Welcome back, my people. I'm your host, Aida Jogelli. Today, you'll be learning about two methods central banks use to manage the money supply, i.e. the two money printers. Plus, I'll show you which money printer is the most inflationary, helicopter money or quantitative easing. Before we begin, you must be wondering, what is the money supply in the United States today? Well, you're in luck. Here is how to see exactly how much cash has been put into circulation. Just go to one of my favorite websites for economic data and a prime source for many investors and traders, the Federal Reserve Bank of San Luis. What is the M2 money supply? So this is the chart of M2 money stock, which measures the money supply that is in savings deposits and the money located in funds that are easily convertible to cash, such as money market funds. The x-axis shows the years from 1960 to 2021, and the y-axis shows the amount of cash in billions of dollars. As we can see, it has been going up slowly and steadily in the past, and recently it has took off almost exponentially. Since 1959, the money supply has gone up over 7,000%.
7,000!
And since the year 2020, the Fed managed to increase the money supply in savings deposits and money market funds by 34%. So that $100 bill you were holding can only purchase 74 bucks worth of stuff. Your purchasing power got crushed by the Fed's printing press, or more like a push of a button. The Federal Reserve has many tools for monetary policy, i.e. for printing more money. And boy, did they use all the tools they could in 2020. But today, we'll be going over two of them: helicopter money and quantitative easing. During the past year, the government forced certain sectors to stop operating, which caused an economic slowdown. To remediate this, the Fed pushed interest rates down to near zero. Yet, the Fed wanted to provide even more monetary inflation to stimulate spending and hence restart economic activity. So, to continue to mitigate the economic impact of the closures, the government distributed helicopter money. What is helicopter money? Helicopter money is when central banks simply create money out of thin air and directly handed it over to the population, kind of like an airdrop. This is the second tool, other than pushing interest rates down, that they use to increase the money supply. Helicopter money chart. You can see the history of the helicopter money distributed to people here in this chart of federal government current transfer payments to people. In the x-axis, we've got the timeline from 1950s to now. And in the y-axis, the amount of cash in billions of dollars. The first thing to note is that the amount of cash has been steadily increasing every quarter over the past 70 years. And this makes sense because this money is for things like unemployment benefits, which needs to increase to keep pace with inflation. Benefits back in the day would not be enough to afford the same things today. Secondly, in the global financial crisis of 2008, there was a bit more helicopter money than ordinary. Last thing that I'd like you to note is that in 2020, the helicopter money really spiked. Zooming in, there is the first stimulus in 2020, quarter two, of $4.7 trillion. Then there's the second stimulus in 2021, quarter one, of $5 trillion. And finally, there should be a third stimulus in quarter three, but this chart has a data delay, so it ends at quarter two. Okay, up till now, you know how to see the increase in the money supply over time and the distributions of helicopter money over time. Let's learn about quantitative easing. So, even with all this fresh new green, the Fed still opted to use their third monetary policy, quantitative easing, also known as QE for short. What is quantitative easing? QE means the Fed is purchasing government bonds and other financial assets. The Fed is essentially injecting money into the economy by buying assets. And as you may know from the laws of supply and demand, this demand by the Fed for assets pushes the prices up. So this is a way to save the price of bonds from crashing too much. The Fed has no upper limit to QE, so up to today, it continues to purchase assets. How much in assets has the Fed purchased over the years? Let's take a look at the total assets chart, which displays the total value of the assets of all Federal Reserves as reported in the Fed's weekly balance sheet. Ooh, let's take a look. In 2002, the Fed was holding $719 billion in assets. In 2008, over the span of 3 months from September to November, the Fed tripled their assets to $2.1 trillion. And now, since March of 2020, the Fed has doubled their assets to $8.4 trillion. And they are continuing QE, purchasing more assets quite linearly on a weekly basis. Which is more inflationary, helicopter money or quantitative easing? The crazy thing about all these ways to pump up the money supply is that some ways are more inflationary than others. To illustrate this, let's superimpose all the plots together and look for patterns. So here you can see the M2 money stock in blue, which is basically the money supply. You can see the assets are in red, which is assets that's in quantitative easing, the value of the financial assets purchased by the Fed. And lastly, in green, you can see all the transfer payments from the government directly to the people, aka the helicopter money. From 2006 to 2021, whenever quantitative easing has taken place, there has been a bump up in the money supply. Notably, here in 2008, here in 2012, here in 2014, and here in 2020. Note that the amount of cash that went into the money supply was far less than released via quantitative easing. So, where did the rest of the money go? A lot of the money went into the security markets when the bonds were purchased. Also notice that when the Fed decreased the quantitative easing in 2019 by selling those assets, it also took money out of circulation. Now let's take a look at the helicopter money in green. Those also coincide with a bump in the M2 money stock. But look at 2020, when trillions of dollars in helicopter money was airdropped. That cash went straight into people's savings accounts. So, quantitative easing, security purchases by the Fed, mostly goes towards inflating the securities markets, which makes owners of those securities richer, while direct payments from helicopter money inflates the money supply. In other words, it directly decreases your purchasing power for goods and services. So to summarize, which monetary policy is more inflationary, helicopter money or quantitative easing? Helicopter money is by far the most inflationary method of monetary policy because it goes directly and rapidly into people's pockets and boosts demand in assets regardless of whether that purchase actually increases productivity. Helicopter money is more inflationary than quantitative easing. Think back to when people got their stimulus checks. They were using that cash to bid up the prices of bicycles and video cards, you name it. Heck, if there was something you liked, you can now buy more of it. And that, mis amigos, is how things with fixed prices quickly went out of stock. The price wasn't high enough. It's the basics of supply and demand. So you must be wondering, how inflationary are drops in interest rates? Think of it this way. With easy credit, the bank is deciding to lend money to someone. That person who borrowed the money has to pay it back with interest. So they need to put that money to work in a productive way that yields earnings enough to cover the interest payment and ideally make a profit for themselves. There'll be people who don't succeed in making a profit, like those who mistimed a speculative bubble. Others might not even be able to pay back the loan, perhaps people who didn't make good business decisions. And then there are people who actually put the money into productive work and hence moved the economy. I am Aida Jageli. Thanks for learning with me today, and I'll see you in the next one. That's all, folks.
Catch new episodes of The Jageli Show. Plus, get exclusive content for free only on jageli.com. Go to jageli.com and sign up now.